So, we the people of India, staying at present in South Korea, strictly denounce and sharply condemn in the hardest possible words the enactment of the Citizenship Amendment Act. Modi-led BJP government at the center, using its full majority, can unopposedly pass any law in the parliament, but this is not why they have been elected. They still have to satisfy the remaining 55% of the masses who did not vote for BJP, as we believe that they have not been elected to further marginalize the already marginalized sections of the society and arbitrarily execute anything which suits their own ideology. This new amendment act stands wholly against the idea of India enshrined in the constitution, which are democracy, secularism, justice and equality. It also does not qualify under Article 14 of the Indian Constitution, which says that the state shall not deny to any person the equality before law or the equal protection of law within the territory of India. This law also fails to satisfy three mandatory criteria mentioned in Article 14, which need to comply for it to retain its legal status. Number one is reasonable classification based on intelligible differentia. Number two is aim to achieve a rational objective. And number three is the law should not be arbitrary. However, this law is not in compliance with the above mentioned constitutional clauses, as per the experts. Thus, we are of the opinion that this law has been enacted to merely suit the communal agenda of the government. Hence, we, the constitution-abiding people of India, pledge to fight this unconstitutional law until it is scrapped and declared null and void by the Supreme Court. Our fight and struggle is not limited to CAA. The government had initially planned to launch a nationwide NRC, which the Home Minister Amit Shah had mentioned in the parliament on record. PM Modi, however, took a surprising U-turn, brazenly stating that there have been no talks of NRC anywhere, which is a white lie on the face of 1.32 billion Indians. The next day after his U-turn, a sum of ₹3,900 crore, or equivalent to $546.6 million, was cleared by the cabinet for NPR, which is the National Population Register, planned to be the basis of NRC. This is again a betrayal with the people of India. They talked of good governance during NDA 1. If this is their good governance, we the people of India reject it. Why can't a single person in BJP today dare to clarify the relation between CAA, NPR and NRC? Where does this money come from? Does it come from their personal account or the taxpayers of India? They want to confuse us. They want to confuse us, but less do they know that we the people of India stand disillusioned by their deceitful lies. We know that CAA, NPR and NRC are closely linked to each other, which the Home Minister has on record clarified chronologically along with other leaders talking about it since NDA 1. We want to question our fellow Indians. We want to question our fellow Indians who are supporting CAA by invoking the logic that NRC has not been drafted yet and making a case that this is not against the Indian Muslims. We want to ask them that would you oppose NRC when it already becomes a law? This is as illogical as saying that, hey, wait until the bomb is dropped on you. Protest after the bomb is dropped on you. What will be left to protest when the law would already be enacted, provided the government has all the financial and physical infrastructure almost ready for implementation of NRC? Do we need to ask them for the explanation over the detention centers already constructed in Assam and Karnataka? Are those detention centers already constructed to house stray cattle? You should fool around someone else but the people of India. We the people of India want to ask that who will be filtered out when you will take back all the non-Muslims and grant them citizenship under CAA? Are you building concentration camps for Muslims in India? Are you inspired by Nuremberg laws enacted by German Reichstag, wherein Jews were stripped of their citizenship and only Germans were considered to be the genuine citizens of Germany? Are you turning Gandhi's inclusive India into Hitler's exclusive Germany? Is this how you respect unity and diversity? You will have to take the responsibility of putting the soul of India on fire at the times. At the times when economy is tanking, when GDP is on ventilator, when your own advisors are voicing concern against these things, when your Make in India has proved to be the biggest hoax, when India has slipped to 102nd position in the Global Hunger Index, when inequality is touching skies, when the Gini coefficient is all set to make India one of the most unequal countries of the world, when exports are falling down, when banks are on the verge of becoming bankrupt, when the taxation system of India has been fudged up by you, when your finance ministers are yoga graduates, when you are manipulating the financial data every now and then to befool the world as if the world doesn't understand this gimmick, when all the top financial and research organizations of this world have shown you a red card, when the lowest strata of the society do not have the money to buy biscuits and undergarments, when the automobile sector is facing lockdown and worst business scenario at present, when despite of increasing population, the demand is continuously shrinking, when you are giving corporate tax cuts and charging common people for everything, when the farmer suicide rate has been record high in your tenure, when your Swachh Bharat, Jan Dhan Yojana, Digital India, Smart Cities campaign, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, women security all failed blatantly, when soldiers don't have good food to eat, when unemployment is at 45 years high and India needs some gush of fresh policies to regain its strength. Is this all you had to offer in such a grave situation? A state of restlessness and perpetual panic? Earlier it was economic, but now social and physical breakdown. You are shooting and bombing in libraries. We condemn the police brutality. You are blocking the exit and suffocating the students with tear gas bombs, shooting with live bullets. Did the protesters who succumbed to bullet injuries shot themselves down? We stand in great solidarity with the students of India who are fighting against your arbitrary, unconstitutional law meant to hurt a particular community. We ask you, was this all necessary? Was this all necessary? Wasn't India functioning in a peaceful manner before you endorsed this riot? Are you calling for a civil war in a peaceful country like India? Your empty talks and superficial care about persecuted minorities stands unscrupulous and bogus when we see that there are minorities which are persecuted for years, like Ahmadiyyas in Pakistan, Hazaras in Afghanistan, Hindu Tamilians in Sri Lanka, Rohingyas in Myanmar, Uyghur Muslims and Tibetans in China. This exposes your vested interest in nurturing and feeding a divisive ideology. Before finishing this memorandum, let me reiterate with emphasis on the most important part of this memorandum, that we believe that the CAA is a pilot project of Modi government, the large scale implementation of which will ensure the undermining of constitution, which is the shield that provides protection to our vulnerable class of the society and to the minorities standing on the margin. Our silence will be their strength. They will further undermine the constitution and oppress other minorities and underprivileged society to suit their interests, and we are well aware of that. As learned Baba Sahib Ambedkar had once said, that there are two types of India, one a privileged India and another an underprivileged India, or Parishkrit Bharat and Bahishkrit Bharat. We want to ensure that the soul of constitution, which ensures equality and justice for including all underprivileged India, for including the underprivileged India or Bahishkrit Bharat, with equitable provisions for them, is not undermined and does not die a death at the hand of a divisive and authoritarian government. When injustice becomes law, resistance becomes duty. A master of taglines, manager of headlines, and the director of all flop shows dancing on his whimsical tunes of destruction has ruined India, and we are here to restore our country, and it begins with the fight against CAA, NPR and NRC. Thank you very much.
Inqilab!
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 Azadi!
NCR se!
Azadi!
NRC se!
Azadi!
CAA se!
Azadi!
And